Celebrating their fifth wedding anniversary in Cuba, Beyonce and Jay-Z blew through the island nation like a tropical storm. Everywhere they went, whether it was the streets of Old Havana,
I really wanted to see her because I like many of her songs.
Their meetings with local artists or dinner at one of the capital's best-known restaurants, the pop power couple's fans were waiting.
They were very nice. They said hello to everyone.
But the trip also made waves all the way back in Miami, where conservative Cuban-American politicians are calling out Beyonce.
I'm calling them out. I'm saying that there are many places that are pleasant. You don't feel like you're being a pawn in the game of this communist tyranny.
Florida Republican Congresswoman Ileana Ross Leighton says she feels betrayed. She fired off a letter to the Treasury Department questioning whether Beyonce and Jay-Z violated U.S. travel restrictions on Cuba.
How nice would it have been if they had said something about freedom and human rights? I'm not saying that they should be politicians, but be sensitive to the cruelty of this regime, what they've done to the people of Cuba. It's just a shame to make it look like an exotic vacation. Shameful.
Cuban-American Florida Senator Marco Rubio, a Republican and rap connoisseur, tweeted that Jay-Z should heed his one-time hit 99 Problems with the hashtag 99 Problems and Dictators Are One. But the Reuters News Service reports Beyonce's vacation was licensed as a cultural exchange, just the kind of trip the president had in mind when he opened up travel to Cuba 2 years ago.
It's certainly the case that under this administration we have eased the ability to travel to Cuba for those purposes.
Beyonce is hardly the first celebrity to travel to Cuba. The Pretenders' lead singer, Chrissy Hynde, told CNN about her visit to the island with a boyfriend 4 years ago.
I just fancy going to Cuba, and I was sitting with him having a coffee, and I said, do you fancy going to Cuba? And he was like, yeah, let's go.
But because of the half-century-old embargo on Cuba and the Castro brothers, Americans are required by law to ask the U.S. government for permission first. Democratic Congresswoman Kathy Castor, who just returned from a trip to Cuba, wants to change that.
I think it's time to try something different and end the embargo and lift these travel restrictions.
It's estimated that thousands of Americans travel to Cuba every year, but an exact number is hard to come by. The Treasury Department, which grants the licenses for travel to Cuba, still won't reveal exactly how many Americans are going to the island. Jim Acosta, CNN, Washington.